إن الحمد لله. Verily, all praise is due to Allah. نحمده. We praise Him. ونستعينه. We seek His assistance. ونستغفره. We ask Him to forgive us. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا. And we seek refuge with Him alone from the evils of our own selves, those sins and those evils that stain our souls. ومن سيئات أعمالنا, and from the bad outcomes of our evil deeds. من يهده الله فلا مضل له, whomever Allah guides, no one can lead him astray. ومن يضلل فلا هادي له, and whomever he leads astray cannot be guided. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, and I testify openly that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. وحده لا شريك له, he's alone in that right, not having any partners. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله, and I testify openly that Muhammad was his servant and messenger. قال الله عز وجل, Allah the Mighty and Majestic has said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا, verily the one who purifies his soul is successful. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا, and the one who stains his soul and ruins it, then he has lost out, he is in loss. And Allah the Mighty and Majestic has said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى, verily the one who attains purity, he purifies himself, then he is successful. وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى, and along with that, he makes mention of the name of his Lord and he prays. From the generality of his tazkiyah, his purity, is that he establishes the salah. Brothers in iman, Allah Ta'ala encourages us in these verses to make tazkiyah, to purify ourselves. And he has announced to his entire creation that whoever purifies their soul, they shall attain success. And in the two verses that we have heard from Surah Al-Shams and Surah Al-A'la, he has left that without further details. But he, Jalla wa Ala, the Majestic and Most High, has explained the reality of that success in other verses. In Surah Taha, Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Allah the Blessed and Most High, has said, وَمَنْ يَأْتِهِ مُؤْمِنًا قَدْ عَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ, and whoever comes to him as a believer, having worked righteous deeds, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, then such people, لَهُمُ الدَّرَجَاتُ الْعُلَىٰ, they shall have the high ranks, meaning the high places and honored places in paradise. As he said, جَنَّاتُ عَدَنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ, gardens of Adan, gardens of paradise under which rivers flow. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they shall abide therein forever. وَذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ مَنْ تَزَكَّى, and that is the recompense for the one who purifies himself, or the one who attains purity. Brothers, purity in Islam, attaining tazkiyah, purification of one's soul, includes that you worship Allah Ta'ala alone, making all of your acts of worship for Him alone. All supplications are directed to Him. All slaughtering is in His name. All oaths are taken in His name. Tawakkul, absolute trust and reliance is upon Him alone. True fear, true love, true hope, all of that is connected to Him, Jalla wa Ala. And then you obey Him. You single Him out with your worship. And then when He orders you with something, you obey Him When he forbids you from something, you refrain and you stay away from that thing. You do so sincerely with ikhlas, with sincerity to him. And you do so with al-ittiba'i, with conformity and following of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the greatest form of tazkiyah. That is the greatest form of purification, that you turn your heart to Allah Ta'ala with all acts of worship, in obedience, in sincerity, and in following the Messenger he has sent to you as a role model, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. We have no power. We have no ability to accomplish anything except through Allah Ta'ala alone. You, by your efforts, are not going to be able to attain purity. No. No matter how dedicated you are by yourself, you shall not attain purity. You shall not attain any rank of purification of your soul unless Allah Ta'ala grants that to you. Think and contemplate over the statement of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, the Blessed and Most High, when he said, وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ. Had it not been for the favor of Allah upon you and His mercy, مَا زَكَى مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ أَبَدًا. Not one of you would ever have attained purity at all. Not one person of you would ever have attained purity. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. However, it is Allah who purifies whomsoever He chooses. وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. And Allah is the all-hearing and the all-knowing. Brothers, if we wish to attain this purity, this piety, the purification of our souls, and thus the favor of Allah, and thus, as a result, paradise with Allah Ta'ala, then we must single Him out with worship. We must beg Him that He makes us from those who attain this level of purification. We must beg Him and ask Him that He purify our souls. We must refrain from al-fahsha and al-munkar. We must refrain from the filthiest of sins, the greatest of sins, those of a vile, indecent sexual nature like fornication, adultery, homosexuality, and all of the pathways and steps that lead to that terrible illicit behavior called fahsha or fawahish. And we must avoid al-munkar in general, evil deeds in general, violations of the orders of Allah Ta'ala, contradiction to His guidance, falling into His prohibitions, not fulfilling our obligations. We must avoid these munkarat. Everything that Allah Ta'ala has forbidden is munkar. The drinking of alcohol, intoxication, whether through weed or through pills or through powders and so on. Intoxication, gambling, involvement in what comes under the non-Muslims' systems of guidance, of rallies, protests, demonstrations and the likes. We must avoid them and pay attention to the deen of Allah and allow the book and the sunnah to guide us in how we are going to reform ourselves and our families and our communities and our cities. We need to avoid every single thing that is munkar, because the evil deeds, they are only done in following the footsteps of a shaytan, of Iblis, the devil. And that is understood from the statement of Allah Ta'ala, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who have believed, La tattabi'u khutuwat ash-shaytan. Do not follow the footsteps of a shaytan. وَمَنْ يَتَّبِعْ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And whoever does follow in the footsteps of a shaytan, فَإِنَّهُ يَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Then he orders his followers to be engaged in fahsha, illicit deeds of a sexual and vile, corrupt nature, and munkar, evil deeds of a sinful nature in general. Then Allah Ta'ala says right after this warning, He says, وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ And had it not been for the favor of Allah upon you, وَرَحْمَتُهُ And His mercy, مَا زَكَى مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ أَبَدًا Then none of you would have ever attained any level of purification. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءُ However, it is Allah that purifies whomever He so chooses. So if we wish to attain purification in the religion and thus paradise, we must avoid al-fahsha'i wal-munkar and following in the footsteps of a shaytan. Three matters, brothers, in iman that you must avoid, you must shun, you must be on guard against them if you wish to attain purity. If you wish to purify your soul, you need to be on guard against these three matters. They are al-kasal, laziness, al-jubn, cowardice, and al-bukhul, stinginess. You need to avoid laziness, as laziness will take away your ambition to do anything to please Allah and lead you into all types of foul behavior. Think about how Allah Jalla wa Ala described the hypocrites, saying, "Inna al-munafiqina yukhadi'un Allah wa huwa khadi'uhum." The hypocrites, they seek to deceive Allah, but it is Allah who deceives them. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى And when they stand for prayer, the hypocrites, they stand as lazy people. From Surah An-Nisa. Rather, the believer, he's firm and he's resolute, he's ambitious to do good, he's vigilant about staying away from evil, he seeks to improve and strengthen his iman throughout his life, hoping to become a strong believer, as described by the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. احرص على ما ينفعك Be vigilant about what benefits you. واستعن بالله And seek the assistance of Allah. ولا تعجز And do not be lazy. And as for cowardice, then the coward does not advise his brothers. The coward does not defend the religion of Islam. The coward is unable to aid the oppressed. The coward is unable to confront anything in a way that ever brings about any good. Cowardice is a trait that no believer wants any part of. Rather, courage and bravery is the attribute of a strong believer. And the strong believer, al-mu'minu al-qawiyu khayrun wa ahabbu ila Allahi min al-mu'min al-da'if. The strong believer who's brave, who's courageous, who's generous and not stingy, who's ambitious, he is better and more beloved to Allah than the weak believer. And as for stinginess, then brothers in iman, وَمَنْ يَبْخَلْ فَإِنَّمَا يَبْخَلُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ As for the one who's stingy, then he is only stingy as it relates to his own self. وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِيُّ وَأَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ And Allah is the all-sufficient, independent, not in need of His creation. And you are the poor, impoverished, from Surah Muhammad, the 38th verse. So the bakhil, the stingy one, he doesn't love for his brother what he loves for himself. Everything of good, he loves it for himself, and he doesn't love for his brother what he loves for himself. And we will not become believers with this level of stinginess in our hearts. We beg Allah Ta'ala that He purify us from stinginess, that He purify our souls from cowardice, that He purify our souls from laziness, that He guide us away from al-munkar and al-fahsha, evil deeds and vile, corrupt actions, and that He guide us and plant us firmly upon al-iman wal-amal salih, faith and righteous deeds. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Ever Merciful, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord, Creator and Sustainer for all things. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihi al-ameen. May Allah raise the rank of and grant peace to His trustworthy messenger, Nabiyyina Muhammad, our Prophet Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, and likewise that of his family and companions, all of them in entirety. Brothers in Iman, believers in Allah, we must be warned of stinginess, cowardice, and laziness. We must be warned against munkar and fahsha, evil deeds, and foul, illicit sexual misbehavior. And we must know that these things will stain our souls. They will corrupt the fabric of our souls. They will destroy our hearts from within if we do not repent from them and seek to stay far away from them. And if that happens to us, and our souls are polluted, stained and destroyed, and we are corrupt from within, then four terrible matters will happen to us in this life. Knowledge will come to us but not produce any benefit. We will not be able to recognize good and embrace it, nor would we be able to recognize evil and shun it. Knowledge would come to us and be of no benefit. We would have hearts that have no submissiveness or humility within them, hardened, crippled, diseased, or even dead hearts like rocks in our chests that don't hear any guidance. We beg Allah Ta'ala for refuge. We would have souls with cravings that are never fulfilled. We will desire and desire and never reach any satisfaction in this life. Pure torture within one person's soul, that he seeks satisfaction and gratification through so many things, yet at every turn he's deprived and he never gains any satisfaction or contentment in this life. We beg Allah for refuge with him. And lastly, we will raise our hands to Allah Ta'ala and we will receive no answer. All of these matters are indicated in a very special supplication that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to use on a regular basis. And Zayd ibn Arqam radiyallahu anhu narrates that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to continually supplicate with this supplication. And I beg that you pay attention. And those of you good at memorization, memorize it. And those of you who can access through your technology the recording of today's khutbah, go back and single out the end of the khutbah for this dua. Memorize it. Embrace it. Supplicate with it. Because it can be a key, by the permission of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, for us to purify the filth that is found in our souls and to rid our hearts of the stains and the corruption that are the effects of our bad actions. That dua that he used to say was collected by Imam Muslim in his sahih, authentic compilation of hadith. So it is an authentic narration. He used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasal. Oh Allah, I ask you to give me refuge from laziness and inability. Al-ajiz, from inability, from being incapable. And al-kasal, by choice, being lazy. Wal-jubni wal-bukhli, and from cowardice, and from stinginess. Wal-harami wa-adhabi al-qabri, and from feeble old age, and from a punishment in the grave. That's the first part of the dua, and the dua has three parts. The second part is Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha. Oh Allah, grant my soul its piety. Wazakkiha, and purify it. You are begging Allah for purification of your soul. Wazakkiha, anta khayru man zakkaha. You are the best to purify it. Anta waliyuha wa mawlaha. You are its caretaker and the one responsible for it. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika. Again, in the third part, more seeking refuge. Oh Allah, I ask you to grant me refuge. Min ilmin la yanfa', from knowledge that does not produce any benefit. Wa min qalbin la yakhsha, and from a heart that has no surrender, servitude, humility, submission to Allah. Wa min nafsin la tashba', and from a soul that never attains any contentment. وَمِن دَعْوَةٍ لَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهَا. And I seek refuge with you from a supplication that goes unanswered. One more time, brothers in iman. اللهم إني أعوذ بك. Oh Allah, I ask you to give me refuge. مِنَ الْعَجْزِ وَالْكَسَلِ, from incapability and laziness. وَالْجُبْنِ وَالْبُخْلِ, and from cowardice and stinginess. وَالْهَرَمِ وَعَذَابِ الْقَبْرِ, and from feeble old age and a punishment in the grave. اللَّهُمَّ آتِ نَفْسِ تَقْوَاهَا. Oh Allah, give my soul its piety. وَزَكِّهَا, and purify it. أَنْتَ خَيْرُ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. You are the best to purify it. أَنْتَ وَلِيُّهَا وَمَوْلَاهَا. You are its caretaker and the one responsible for it. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika. Oh Allah, I ask you to give me refuge with you. Min ilmin la yanfa', from a knowledge that does not provide any benefit. Wa min qalbin la yakhsha', and from a heart that does not have any submissiveness. Wa min nafsin la tashba', and from a soul that does not attain any contentment or satisfaction. وَمِن دَعْوَةٍ لَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهَا. And I seek refuge with you from a supplication that goes unanswered. Imagine, Abdullah, if Allah were to grant you what you asked for at this time. Imagine being granted these matters. Supplications that are answered by Allah. Hearts that reflect and ponder and lead you to good action. Souls that are content, happy, fulfilled and satisfied with the obedience of Allah and with the provisions that He has given you. SubhanAllah, knowledge that when it comes to you is a source of joy and happiness, opening up ease and mercy for you in this life and the next life. We beg Allah Ta'ala that He grant us refuge with Him from incapability, laziness, cowardice, stinginess, feeble old age, and punishment of the grave. We ask Him to purify our souls, as He is the best one to purify the souls. We ask Him to grant us piety in our hearts. He is the one who takes care of our hearts and our souls. He is the caretaker of those matters. We ask Allah Ta'ala that He grant us knowledge that benefits, and that He gives us refuge with Him from knowledge that doesn't benefit. We ask Him for hearts that are fearful and submissive. We beg Him for refuge with Him from hearts that have no submissiveness. We ask Him for souls that are content and satisfied. And we beg Him for refuge with Him from souls that reach no contentment. We ask Him for supplications that are responded to. And we seek refuge with Him from being stranded in this life, having supplications that go unanswered. وَصَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ وَسَلِّمْ وَبَارِكْ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ.